Good morning, my dear students. Today we are discussing about the insect vector, that is Culex. Culex is a genus of mosquito which serves as a vector of one or more important diseases of birds, humans and other animals. These are distributed worldwide in tropical and temperate regions. They feed at night on humans and animals, and they are also found indoor and outdoor. Morphologically, the insect body has been divided into head, thorax and abdomen, and it measures about 4 to 10 mm. It has one pair of wings. The wings are unspotted. Buzzing noise are produced by beating of wings. All types of mosquito must have water to complete their life cycle, and they are preferred the small water bodies of which contains the organic matter such as tin cans, bird baths or rain barrel. Coming to the life cycle of Culex species, it continues or it completed with the four stages: egg, larva, pupa and the adult. Female mosquitoes lay egg on the surface of fresh stagnant water. Most eggs hatch within 48 hours and the larvae live in water and they develop into pupae in 5 days. The pupae live in water. They develop into adult flying mosquitoes in 2 to 3 days. Coming to the role in disease transmission, it is Culex is commonly called it as common house mosquito, and that will transfer many of the viruses. The diseases which are caused are West Nile fever, St. Louis encephalitis, Japanese encephalitis as a viral diseases of birds and horses, and also they are able to transmit the parasitic disease, that is lymphatic filariasis. So when you differentiate between the three important species, that is Anopheles, Culex and the Aedes. So Anopheles and the Culex, they are active during dawn and dusk, but also they are active during the night, whereas the aggressive day biter, it is the Aedes. So first disease to be caused by this Culex, that is West Nile fever. So this is a arthropod borne flavivirus, and it is originated and isolated from the West Nile province of Uganda in 1937. So this, there are three important aspects, that is amplifier host, one is the insect vector and the dead end host. Here the mosquitoes are infected by biting infected birds, and those are transmitted to humans, horses and mammals by infected mosquitoes. Infected mosquito can also pass the virus to more number of birds, and birds are natural virus reservoirs. So now, here in the West Nile fever, in the human, it causes malaria and also rashes and lymph adenopathy. So, and also it causes many serious neurological diseases. So coming to the symptoms, that is when a patient is suffering from West Nile fever, he will be having certain symptoms: fever, swollen lymph glands, nausea or vomiting, muscle aches and joint pain. So the treatment, there are no certain vaccine for this disease, only there are a supportive therapy which includes hospitalization, antibiotics, respiratory support and intravenous fluids. Coming to the part of prevention, so prevention, avoid mosquito infested areas, clearing leaving spaces of standing water, and also use insect repellent. By doing all this, you can control the insect vector. So next one, it is Japanese encephalitis. So encephalon, it is an area of the central nervous system which includes higher, that means which enclosed with the skull, which continues with the spinal cord. And encephalitis, it is nothing but the inflammation of the brain. Here, Japanese encephalitis is a mosquito-borne viral infection. It is leading cause of viral encephalitis in Asia. Humans can get the disease when a mosquito that carries the virus bites them. Japanese encephalitis virus is related to the virus that caused St. Louis encephalitis, Murray Valley encephalitis, West Nile virus, dengue fever, and also yellow fever. So this virus is a flavivirus family. The Culex mosquito passes it on. Here, a host is a source of virus and the vector passes it on. Wild birds are likely to be the natural host of Japanese encephalitis and mosquitoes are the vector. A vector does not cause disease but it passes. Pathogenesis, virus enter the body through the bite of insect. By the insect vector, that is mosquito. After multiplication in reticuloendothelial system, where exactly the host defense where exactly the ability to inhibit the virus hemagglutination, here viremia of varying duration ensues. That means when there is the presence of viruses in the blood, we call it as viremia. And the virus, when they are accumulated in the blood, they are transported to the target organ, that is to the brain, via blood. And these viruses proliferate and damage the neuronal tissue, thereby elicits nervous manifestations. Coming to the signs and symptoms, so there are two types where exactly infection can occur. First one, it is the mild infection and severe infection. Symptom usually appear after 6 to 8 days after the mosquito bite. Mild infection, no apparent symptoms except fever and headache, whereas severe infection, which includes high fever, headache, neck stiffness, disorientation, tremors, coma, occasional convulsions, and also spastic paralysis. So in case of Japanese encephalitis, it can be, their fatal rate, it is up to 30%, and 30% the patients are suffering and a serious with the brain damage including paralysis. And these could be diagnosed a test which is based on blood and also cerebrospinal fluid. Coming to the preventive measures, the vector control, nothing but the mosquito control. Eliminate mosquito breeding areas by chemical larvicides, biolarvicides, and environmental management. Adult and larval control, that is anti-larval treatment, and also vaccination and personal protective measures. Avoid prime mosquito hovers from dusk to dawn, indoor spray and foraging, and use of insecticides. Second one, that is St. Louis encephalitis. It is also mosquito-borne St. Louis encephalitis virus. It is related to Japanese encephalitis virus, and where exactly this affects the US, and also the cases have been reported in Mexico and Canada. And the incubation period of St. Louis encephalitis, it is ranges from 5 to 15 days, and the fatality rate, it is low in case of St. Louis encephalitis, it is about 5 to 15%, and the risk factor what you observed, it is in the aged people. The disease of St. Louis encephalitis, it is milder in case of children and the adult, and the 40% of the children and the young adults may develop this disease only with the fever and the headache, and also they may suffer from the, that is a meningitis. It is nothing but the inflammation where you can found in the membranes of the brain plus spinal cord. Whereas 90% of the elderly person with this disease, they develop encephalitis, nothing but the inflammation in the brain. St. Louis encephalitis, it is transmitted to humans through the bite of mosquito. And here you can see in this picture, you can see the mosquito vector. Second one, birds are primary amplifying vertebrate host. Humans and the mammals, they are the dead end host. And clinical symptoms ranges from mild illness to frank encephalitis, that is inflammation in the brain. And flu-like symptoms and the general illness are also seen in the case of St. Louis encephalitis. And this is prevalent in the eastern and central United States. And it is severe in case of elderly person, and the mortality rate is about 5 to 20%, you can see, in case of St. Louis encephalitis. So when you come for the transmission, the common vector of this disease, it is the Culex, it is common house mosquito. And the infected mosquito then transmit the St. Louis encephalitis virus to humans and animals during the feeding process. The St. Louis encephalitis virus grow both in infected mosquito and the infected bird, but does not make either one sick. Only infected mosquito can transfer or transmit St. Louis encephalitis virus. Once a human has been infected with the virus, it is not transmissible from that individual to other humans. Coming to the symptoms, the majority of the infection results in mild illness including fever and headache. Whereas the infection will be similar in case of Japanese encephalitis and St. Louis encephalitis, which includes, that is, headache, high fever, neck stiffness, stupor, disorientation, coma, tremors, occasional convulsion and the paralysis. As earlier told, the fatality ranges from 3 to 30%, and the elderly people are more likely to have the fatal infection. Coming to the treatment, that is, there is no vaccine for the treating this disease, but only thing, the use of interferon alpha 2b may decrease the severity of the complications or the symptoms. Prevention, so this is, when you see this disease, the only way is to avoid the mosquito bite during the day and the night time. And also you can use insect repellent, wear long sleeved shirts and pants, treat clothing and take steps to control the mosquitoes indoor as well as the outdoor. Use of insect repellents, that is DEET, picaridin, oil of lemon, eucalyptus, paramethendiol, eudecanon, that is PMD2. This can be used as an insect repellent. And other preventive measures, that is use of a screen on windows and doors, use air condition if available, stop mosquito from laying eggs in or near water. So empty all the tires, buckets, planter, toys, pools which contains the water. Check for water holding containers both indoors and outdoors. This is how we can control the insect vector, nothing but the mosquito in disease transmission. Next one, that is lymphatic filariasis, which is globally considered as neglected tropical disease, is a parasitic disease which is caused by the microscopic thread-like worms. The adult worms only live in the human lymph system. The lymph system maintains the body's fluid balance and fights infection. Lymphatic filariasis is spread from person to person by mosquito. Coming to the causative agent of lymphatic filariasis include mosquito-borne filarial nematodes, that is Uchereria brancofti, Brugia malayi and Brugia timori. But the 90% of the lymphatic filariasis, it is caused by Uchereria brancofti, and the name it has been, that is Brancoftian filariasis. So this is how exactly the cycle goes. The first one, the mosquito takes a blood meal, and next, that is where you can see the infective stages. So it male and female, you can see in the adult in lymphatics, and later on adults produce sheathed microfilaria that migrate into the lymph and blood channels. Mosquito takes a blood meal and that they ingest the microfilaria. Microfilaria shed sheath, penetrate mosquito's midgut and migrate to thoracic muscle. So next the larval stage, like that migrate to the head and mosquito's proboscis. And this is how exactly that is the mosquito stages and the human stages. Later on the same cycle repeats in case of that is Uchereria brancofti. Coming to the symptoms of lymphatic filariasis, that is asymptomatic, patients have hidden damage to the lymphatic system and also kidney, whereas in case of acute attack of filarial fever, where you can see pain and inflammation of lymph nodes and ducts, often accompanied by fever, nausea and vomiting, increase with severity of chronic disease. And the third one, it is the chronic elephantiasis and hydrocele, where swelling of scrotum in males or enlarged breast in case of females. Here is the picture which shows about lymphatic filariasis. This is the third symptom, that is chronic symptom. Coming to the treatment, the main goal of treatment of an infected person is to kill the adult worm. Diethyl carbamazine citrate, DEC, which is both microfilaricide and active agonist adult worm, is the drug of choice for the lymphatic filariasis. The drug will kill both the microfilaria, which is a most infective stage, and also it will kill the adult worms. DEC has been used worldwide for more than 50 years. Coming to the preventive measures, at night, sleep in an air-conditioned room or sleep under a mosquito net, nothing but avoiding the insect vector. Between dusk and dawn, wear long sleeves and trouser and use mosquito repellent on exposed skin. Another approach to prevention includes giving entire communities medicine that kill the microscopic worms and also controlling mosquito. Thank you.